On August 10, 2025, the time gauge outside the Coast Guard station in Juneau, Alaska, began recording some unusual readings. The water level was strangely fluctuating, not due to tides or a passing ship, and this seemingly caused the water in the harbor to behave in an unusual manner. Unbeknownst at the time, a series of tsunami waves had just struck the shoreline of Alaska's capital city. The tsunami in question peaked in height at 33 centimeters or 13 inches, involving several waves that continued onwards for multiple hours. And, strangely enough, this tsunami was not generated from some regional large magnitude earthquake. Instead, it was triggered by a massive, albeit unobserved, landslide 62 miles to the southeast. This landslide was registered as a magnitude 3.3 earthquake, seemingly marking wind between what I estimate was 30 million to 70 million cubic meters of rock and ice rapidly collapsed. This occurred in a portion of the Tracy Arm within a fjord at 5:26 a.m. local time, just after the sun rose. Remember, all that is needed for a tsunami to be generated is for a large volume of water to be displaced in a body of water, which is exactly what this landslide did. As to why it was picked up and registered as an earthquake, anything that causes sudden motions of rock generates seismic waves, whether that be from explosions, earthquakes, very large volcanic eruptions, or even landslides. Thus, seismic waves equivalent in amplitude to that of a magnitude 3.3 earthquake were created and subsequently measured via the landslide in question, even though it did not in actuality generate a true earthquake. However, while the resolution of regional seismometers is high, I am a bit suspicious that the actual landslide location was a few thousand feet west-northwest of where the current location is pinned. With that out of the way, there are currently no photos of the area in question or the close tsunami wave heights, so what I am about to say is pure speculation. While some sources are claiming that the tsunami waves never reached above 15 feet in height within a few miles of their origin, my own modeling suggests that tsunami waves at least reached a height of 11.3 meters or 37.1 feet at a spot around 6 miles west of the slide's origin. Using this non-official model, these are potential wave height ranges for much of the Tracy Arm, with tsunami wave heights still reaching up to a foot high as far as 96 miles away, as denoted by this yellow outline. While it was initially claimed that there was no damage due to the remoteness of where the tsunami's largest wave struck and the tsunami's overall small size, this claim was later proven incorrect. As, when the landslide occurred, there were three people camping on Harbor Island. While they got away just fine, what did not was one of their kayaks and a decent chunk of their camping equipment, which was washed away unexpectedly above the high tide line. The people in question are thankfully now back in more populated parts of Alaska. So, why did this major landslide, which is one of the largest to hit Alaska in decades, happen? I have a strong hunch that it is the same reason the Henderson Lagoon was the site of a tsunami in 2024 and why Tan Fjord experienced a true mega-tsunami in 2015, rising temperatures causing glacial retreat. I want you to quickly look at the topography of the Tracy Arm. It is absurdly rugged, with many cliff faces approaching or exceeding slopes of 50 or even 60 degrees. These were all created during the Pleistocene glacial periods when incredibly large and thick volumes of glacial ice bulldozed and carved their way through existing rock faces to form a distinguishable series of U-shaped valleys. However, since 1850, almost every single glacier in Alaska has been retreating due to rising world temperatures, which are more pronounced the closer to the poles you get. Thus, when the glacier did exist to a longer and thicker extent, its mass held up many otherwise unstable slopes, preventing them from collapsing. But, as the glacier retreated and got thinner, it ceased holding up a portion or all of said unstable slopes, causing some of them to eventually collapse all at once as a large landslide. For now, in my opinion, I would not recommend visiting within the deep interior of the Tracy Arm as the relevant collapse site could theoretically still be unstable and prone to producing additional, although presumably smaller, landslides. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Howard Kagan, for supporting my work.